you. The Riverside County Sheriff's Department is mourning the loss of a veteran deputy who was shot and killed during a traffic stop. The deputy was killed by 44-year-old William McKay, who had an extensive criminal history stretching back to the 1990s. The Riverside County Sheriff is claiming that this death would not have happened if that suspect had been kept in prison. KTLA 5's Shelby Nelson is live in Jurupa Valley with the very latest. Hi, Shelby.
Hi there, Lou. Yeah, dozens of people have showed up to a growing memorial at the entrance of the Jurupa Valley Sheriff Station here. Take a look right behind me. You've got family and friends who have come out here, as well as just members of the community who didn't even know Deputy Isaiah Cordero, but were saddened at the news of what happened to him yesterday. So that's why you're seeing a lot of those candles, those flowers laid out. We do want to get right to some new information we just learned about when that shooting first happened yesterday. Let's show you some surveillance video first. And you're looking at surveillance video that shows moments after the shooting happened yesterday, just before 2 p.m. You can hear a resident come out saying, call 911. They see the deputy, they see his motorcycle, and they're in complete panic. Both women say they were working inside the house when it happened. They heard a gunshot, ran out, and had to call 911 three times because they just could not get through. That was one of the most frustrating parts for them, they say, was seeing a deputy down, calling 911, but not being able to get through immediately because the line was busy. Now, in all, they say it took about 10 minutes from the first call to the time they got through and when other deputies started to arrive. Now, earlier today, the family of 32-year-old Isaiah Cordero came out here because they wanted to meet the women who called 911 and who were persistent in trying to help. The family did not speak to us, but the 911 callers did.
You call 911, you see what's happening. Was the black truck still here?
No, it was gone already. He fled the scene. It was scary. I felt hopeless at first, as I didn't know what to do. I just followed dispatcher's instructions. It was just a scary scene. It was difficult. It was something very difficult to live. I never experienced anything like it. And I just want the family to know that we tried our best to help.
And this is Deputy Cordero, who the Riverside County Sheriff says had been hired onto the department back in 2014. He moved his way up, and in September, he completed motor school and was working motorcycle enforcement out of the Jurupa Valley Station. Now, yesterday afternoon, Deputy Cordero was conducting a traffic stop when authorities say the suspect, 44-year-old William Shae McKay, pulled out a gun and shot Cordero, killing him. He then led deputies on a chase through IE freeways before it all came to an end on the 15 freeway in Norco. Authorities say McKay fired at deputies, who then returned fire, killing him. Yesterday in a press conference, Sheriff Chad Bianco was adamant that McKay should not have been free in the first place after being convicted of his third strike last year in a case involving kidnapping and assault. We'll have more on that later, but again, a memorial grows out here, and today we did speak with a cousin of Deputy Cordero who works with the San Bernardino County Sheriff. Take a listen to what he had to say.
Right now, we're just trying to deal with it. We're suffering, you know, trying to remember the great times we had with him. And it's just really tough on us right now. He loved motorcycles. He just graduated the motor unit academy for Riverside, I believe. He was just became one in September, so he loved riding motorcycles. He was always lively. He brought the light to the dark room, and just a loving cousin, motivator. He was just all around great person, funny, loving, was always there for you whenever you needed him.
Such a tragic situation. Now, coming up a little bit later on at 5, you will hear more from those two women who called 911 immediately after hearing that gunshot right outside their house. But for now, reporting live in Jurupa Valley, I'm Shelby Nelson, KTLA 5 News.